Okay, so in this lecture what we are going to cover is time management and WBS. WBS stands for work breakdown structure. Okay, we look at the objectives of this lecture. We will first look a little bit at time management, specifically from the standard, and get an overview of what are the various elements of time management. Look at the basics of work breakdown structure, and then look at some of the simple tools which are used today for time management. And in the next lecture, we'll go on to more sophisticated tools. And as we know, a lot of this sessions will be on the time management tools. Now, I'd like to take you back to what we discussed in the first few classes as to plan, monitoring, and control, or the PDCA cycle. Now, do you recall this? So, what was the example we discussed when we talked about plan, monitor, and control? Yeah, so I gave you an example where we are traveling from say IIT campus to Chennai, and how you can plan, how you can monitor, and how you can control. So what was the tools we used there?
Bike.
Is that the tool?
No.
Watch. Time.
Yeah.
Time.
So one was what did you use to plan, and what did you use to control?
Google Maps
was used to plan. Yes. What is used to control?
Time.
Watch. And you needed some kind of milestones or locations. Okay, so the same concept applies to construction projects or project management also. If you go in and look at what planning is, it's basically developing a strategy for executing a project in order to meet project objectives. It's extremely important. Do is executing project with the intent to meet the objectives. Monitoring. And this is where the important phase starts in terms of the feedback loop, gathering data on actual project progress and comparing with the plan to evaluate compliance with the plan. And control or act is decision making on interventions required during the execution of the project to keep the project on track in order to meet objectives. So this is the what you we call the complete cycle of or how we need to do to manage a project. Now, when we go into the time management aspect specifically, we have to apply the plan, do, check, act, or the plan, man, monitor, control cycle here. And you can see that in the project management body of knowledge, okay, you can see the project management body of knowledge. These are the sub clauses in the time management clause. So clause 6 is time management, and you can see that we have activity definition. We have activity sequencing, activity resource estimating, duration estimating, schedule development, schedule control. So these are the basics of time management. Now, the way the PMBOK defines you discusses it, you have various inputs, different tools and techniques, and outputs for each of these clauses. So what I would ask you to think about is, if we take these 6 clauses, which of this is planning, which of this is monitoring, which of this is control?
Planning would be sequencing.
No. Planning will be what?
6.1, 2, 3, 4.
Even 5 is planning.
5 is planning.
Okay. So you will find most of it comes into the planning side. The monitoring and the control is actually 6. So when we actually talk about control, you will find that control is really based on project requirements. So we might not be able to give a specific detailed standard for it, okay. But 6.6 talks both about the monitoring and about the control part, whereas you can see the amount of information given in planning, amount of steps in planning, it's far more detailed. Now, one of the critical aspects when you look at planning is everything is made up of activities, right? So if you look, go back to the clauses, see activity definition, activity sequencing, activity resource estimating. So the key of what we are doing in the planning phase especially is on activities, okay. So we really have to get used to this term activities, because that's what a project is finally made up of. That's what we look at a project and we say, we look at a project as it is. We look at it comprised of multiple activities, and what we have to do is to be able to identify all the activities, which is a key step, and just complete. If I take a project, break it down to its activities and make sure all activities are completed, I have basically taken care of the project. Okay, and as you can see in the graphics here, this is a very common problem solving approach. Okay, so you have a problem, you divide it into sub problems, you then divide it into further sub problems, you solve all the sub problems, put it back together and you get the solution. Any idea on what this kind of approach is typically called?
Work breakdown structure is
one of the steps towards it. The breaking down is, but there is a more common term. It is called divide and conquer. Okay, so we have all heard about this, it is commonly used. So you are basically dividing something into small tasks, taking care of the small things and then putting it back together. And you know, it's a common concept and approach we use for complex tasks. So a project is complex, we approach it by the divide and conquer approach. Now here we have some examples of what I would say are common projects for you all. You can relate to most of this, whether it's an industry lecture, whether it's organizing a CEA fest, or whether it's a field trip, or whether it's something like Shastra. What I would like you to do is to think about what let's take industrial lecture, it's a fairly simple exercise. What do you think are the activities you would like to, what are the activities that come to mind when you're organizing an industrial lecture? But before I get to the activities, let me take a step back. Is time, what are the objectives of an industrial lecture? Let's take industrial lecture as a project. What are the objectives of an industrial lecture? Want to use the board here? Can you tell me? I mean all of you have organized industrial lectures. What do you think is an objective for an industrial lecture?
And perspective from the industrial side instead of the normal academic.
Okay, so I am calling it content. What are the other objectives?
Motivation, inspiration.
Okay, I would say that part of content, I am using it as a part of content.
Time.
So what about time? I do the industrial lecture, I schedule it at 5 o'clock, the speaker, everything, I mean what speaker comes at 9 o'clock, is the objective met? No. I schedule the industrial lecture at 5 o'clock, I go, the room is not available. Okay, no. So we see time is an important part of schedule of achieving our objective of the industrial lecture. Is there any other than time? Let's come back to time, but what are the other objectives you could think of? Do you want industrial lecture and lecturer and you alone?
Student.
Yes, student. You want audience? What else do you want? Speaker, content, speaker.
Resources like the projector.
Okay, you want, I am putting resources like good projector, classroom, ambience, everything else. Anything else? Okay, transportation, is it an objective? Is it an objective or is it something that achieves an objective? Is your objective to get really good transportation for your speaker? Is that an objective?
No.
It's something that
you want to meet.
It's something that you have to do to achieve an objective. What about food or tea or coffee? Is that an objective or not?
No.
Will your customer, who's your customer?
The audience
is fully satisfied with just food for thought, or do they need other kinds of food? Okay, so we'll say refreshments. And I'm now putting the last one as time. Okay, so you know that even if all of these objectives, there might be more objectives we can think of, but I just wanted you to go through the exercise of kind of listing that even when you look at a something like a guest lecture, there can be a series of objectives you have to meet, and if you list those objectives and then you start finding how you are going to meet the objectives, you are going to have a better chance of doing so. Now, I have put this objective of time. In how many dimensions are time important? I am kind of using the word dimensions intentionally here. What are the aspects of time that are important for this industrial lecture? Yes, so if I take time, you need start, you need the duration, okay. So these are critical. You have to start at the right time, you have to end at the right time, okay. Now, in order for you to start at the right time, what are the other activities which are important? Yes, transport. So I am going to kind of list it out here. There is transport. What else? This is more brainstorming. I am not trying to do any structure to it now. I am just trying to, what else is important? You want to make sure things start on time. What else is important?
You have to intimate the speaker.
Yes, transport is important, communication.
Time for setting up resources.
Yes, resource availability. You have to make sure, I mean you cannot assume that the hall is free and just walk into it. You have to make sure that it is available at that time, okay. So you have resource availability. Audience availability and communication. Okay, so again you will find that one of your critical parameters here is time, objectives is time, and meeting time is so important. And if we start listing down, you will find that for example, now you, what is the activity you do? So we are trying to now break up your project into objectives, and objectives into deliverables, and then the deliverables have to be, there are certain activities which have to be done to achieve the deliverable. So let's take a little further. I can go to the next level. I take audience availability. What do I have to do? How do I ensure audience is available?
Publicity. Organize the schedule such that it will be in the feasible hours.
Like yes, I have to look for clashes. Okay, so you know, clashes. I have to then do communication. I have to, you know, might be do long term communication, then short term communication. So this again, lot of activities which go into organizing this industrial lecture. Now, are there any, so the point I wanted to make here is we can take this, start breaking it down. We are dividing and trying to take each bit and manage it separately. We can assign responsibilities to people. We can do so many things around this, which might be things are getting done without a very formal structure, might be we are already doing it, but this adds formality to it. Let's take what do you think among the other three are the next simpler one to organize? Field trip. Which is simpler to organize, field trip or industrial lecture? Probably is little simpler. Field trip has a lot of external work, okay. So I am sure you can go in the same manner and start saying what are your objectives, and then start organizing field trip. Is time important in a field trip?
Yes.
It is very important. Time is one of your primary objectives, starting time, you know, ending time, when you reach, you know, all of these other things are also important. Let us take something like CEF Fest, which is the next one. How is time important in CEFS? Right. Time is critical from many perspectives. Now what are the, so now I come to the question again. What are the dimensions of time that are important? What is the dimension of time that is little different from industrial lecture to CEFS?
There are multiple deadlines.
Yeah, you are on multiple days, multiple events. Multiple starts, multiple finishes. If those finishes don't finish properly, you can't start other events. Okay, so it's more complex, more diamond, more time issues are associated with it. But and I mean very similar to Shastra. Again, complexity just increases. Okay, but the most important part of this exercise is the fact that time plays. Time is an object, and sometimes we don't realize that. We just go about trying to organize things without that very, very specific focus on time.